sweetest heart of Mary Church on this beautiful June day as we celebrate the love of Holly and Chad. We ask God's blessing upon them and upon us all. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus, the love of God, our Heavenly Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
With your spirit.
We pause for a moment now and remember that this wedding is not only about Holly and Chad, but about every one of us. They are the people they are today because of you. Somehow you have impacted them, and they rejoice that you made the effort to be here today, some at a distance, I'm sure. And as we come together, it is a time to renew and deepen our own commitments of love. We pause for a moment and pray for Holly and Chad, but also for ourselves. Almighty God and Father, you have inspired the love of Holly and Chad. May they now enter into a sacramental bond of love with you and each other. According to your will, may their love be creative and fruitful. May they live to see their children's children in this world and come to the wedding banquet of life eternal with all the saints. We pray through Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, and God forever and ever. Amen. We can be seated now as we listen to the readings that Holly and Chad have chosen.
First reading is from Genesis.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air, and he brought them to man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all the wild animals, but none proved to be a suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on man, and while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The man had taken from man one when he brought her to man. The man said, "This one at last is the bone of my bones and the flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of her man this one has been taken. This is why man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one body." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh. Second reading is from Corinthians.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. It is not jealous, it is not pompous. It is not inflated, it is not rude, it does not seek its own interests. It is not quick-tempered, it does not brood over injury, it does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are the merciful, mercy shall be theirs. Blessed are the pure of heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, they shall be called the sons and daughters of God. Blessed are those persecuted for holiness' sake, the reign of God is theirs. Blessed are you when they insult you, persecute you, and utter every kind of slander against you because of me. On that day, rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Ali and Chad and friends all. Every couple have their story, every couple have the way that they met and what's evolved in their relationship. And they have a story ahead of them as well. And as many of you know, Chad and Holly met thanks to the Detroit Pistons. I think Holly was dancing, but you missions or whatever, and Todd was there to put out fires and be a gymnast and show off his skills. So naturally, these two athletic, gifted people were attracted to each other and thought, well, we can do gymnastics together. Team dancing together. We can put out fires together. And so here we are. And what a beautiful thought that the two of you connected so quickly and you appreciated each other and you were able to understand each other very deeply. Both of you never cease smiling. And I know that that's not just because it's your wedding. You were like that when we met in the office. You are happy people and you want to bring joy to each other and even beyond. And it's clear that all these people love you very much and want to share your life journey. And so all of these are wonderful indicators of all the resources that you have. Many family and friends that love you to death and want anything and everything for you and for your well-being. And we're here today then to ask the Lord to also be a strong presence in your life. We chose to have a religious ceremony, not just some other kind of event, and that you wanted specifically something in a beautiful setting such as this that reminds us of history and tradition. And so we build on all that we have received, and we want to pass on what we have received to others. And I know that you will be very energetic, athletic people. You're creative people, dynamic people. I know you're very involved in digital marketing and all kinds of things. So you want to light a few fires, and you want to put a few fires out. But, in any event, the two of you will be a spark, literally, for each other. And part of that spark in your relationship is the Holy Spirit. Is the presence of God. And like all things, a spark needs some assistance at times, that it might grow into a true flame and not sort of taper out and weaken and be dampened. And how do we do that? By prayer. And that is very important, that the two of you talk about how you met God each day. And then to pray together. And not just to add a meal, but to find a time for quality reflection and some dialogue and prayerful reflection. And that's a wonderful idea for all of us. That if we could take some time each day, or certainly each week, and look back over the day or the week and say, where did I meet God? What was God trying to say to me? What is God trying to say to us as a couple? Or as a family? Those are beautiful questions to be able to ask. Pope Francis wrote about this very recently. He put out a special message on the Feast of St. Joseph back in March. And in that message, he talked about the last line of today's gospel, rejoice and be glad. And he said that a Christian is able to rejoice when they are thankful, when they look back and say, what have I experienced? And then discern. That's a Jesuit word. The Pope's a Jesuit. So he said, we discern, or we try to see the signs of what God is doing, and look for patterns in our life, and be grateful, whatever happens. And then to be grateful for the future that's going to unfold. And at the end of the day, to say thank you for what was, and to be able to say thank you for whatever will happen tomorrow and in all the tomorrows to come. And to trust that eventually we will be thanking God forever in His heavenly kingdom. But for now, we can have basketball and other things, other ways that we might be entertained. But certainly, above all, we want to be reflective and prayerful and talk about our faith with each other. Now, if you'd like to come up to declare your vows. Holly and Chad, you have come together here in this beautiful church in the presence of family and friends. Christ abundantly blesses your love, has already consecrated your baptism, and now enriches and strengthens you with that special sacrament that you may assume the duties of marriage, mutual and lasting fidelity. So I ask you these three questions. Hopefully you will answer yes together to these questions. Have you come here freely and without coercion to give yourselves wholeheartedly to each other in marriage?
Yes.
Are you resolved to follow the path of marriage as a vocation in life and to give yourselves faithfully to each other day by day?
Yes.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and the Church?
Yes.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, please join your hands as we declare vows. I, Chad, take you, Holly, to be my wife.
I, Chad, take you, Holly, to be my wife.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Holly, take you, Chad, to be my husband.
I, Holly, take you, Chad, to be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord and his goodness strengthen you and fill you both with his blessings.
The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, be present in your love for each other and through each other. We pray in the name of Jesus the Lord. Amen. Heavenly Father, bless these rings, which Chad and Holly give to one another as a sign of their committed vows of love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Holly, take and wear this ring.
Holly, take and wear this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Chad, take and wear this ring.
Chad, take and wear this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
You are now officially married in the eyes of the church and the state. As a sign of the unity of your lives, I'm sure you'd like to give each other a kiss while we congratulate you and invite the unity camp.
Life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families throughout the world, and for lasting peace among all people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for all members of families who have passed from this world, and for the departed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the church, the holy people of God, and for unity among all Christians, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord.
And now we draw all our prayers together, spoken and those carried in the silence of our hearts, as we pray in the words Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. This time there's a blessing sung for the newly married couple, at the end of which there will be the reception.
May God bless you, hold and keep you. May God's mercy shine on you. Guard your hope and guard your resting. Keep your love forever. May God satisfy your longing, be refreshment at your table, and provide your daily bread. Guard your falling and your coming, keep the solace of your silence, life within the lives you wed. May God join your hopeful spirits, fill your hearts with truth and courage, trust to share both joy and tears. Teach love to your children's children. May your household learn to witness, live in faith through all your years. May God make your home a refuge, where you warmly welcome strangers, and the lowly find a place. Make you caring, kind companions, help you meet the needs of neighbors, finding Christ in every faith. May God bless you, hold and keep you. May God's mercy shine on you. Guard your hope and guard your rest. Keep your love forever new.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The honor to present our newly married couple, Mr. and Mrs. Chad Layton.